Hi friends, my name is Akhil Ahmed, and in this particular video I will show you how to use the for loop container in SSIS. You know, sometimes we need to run a particular task n number of times. So for example, we have a execute SQL task that we want to execute, for example, 20 times. So we can use a for loop container in this particular case, and then you know, just drag and drop the for loop container to the control flow task and then configure it to be run 20 times. And then we can put our execute SQL task into the for loop container. So as soon as the for loop container will iterate through the counter, you know, from 1 to 20, so our execute SQL task that is situated inside the for loop container will also be executed, you know, so it can execute n number of times. So in this particular case, I have AdventureWorks 2014 database on my machine, and there is a table in it, sales.customer. So this particular table has around 19,000 records, and it has a territory ID. And the territory ID, let's see the max territory ID. So we have around 10 territory IDs in this particular table. For example, for a record, the territory ID can be 1, 2, or 3. In this particular case, we will use the for loop container to loop through all the territory IDs in this particular table and then export the data for each territory ID into a separate CSV file. So for example, first of all, the loop will start from territory from 1, so it will go to this particular table and will select all data from this table where territory ID is 1, and then will export that data to a CSV file. The second time, the territory ID will be 2, and it will pick all data from this particular table for territory ID 2, and then will export the data to a CSV file. Let's see like how data will look like. So where territory ID, for example, first we will select all data where territory ID is 1, okay, and then 2. So this way, you know, we will export data to a CSV file. So here we are at the BIDS 2015, and then go to the SSIS toolbox. So first of all, let's create some SSIS variables. Those will be used to configure this particular SSIS package. So first of all, we need a folder directory, you know, the path of the folder where we are going to put our CSV file. So we can name the folder as folder path. It will be of string type, and the value will be C file. So we will put our files at C files. Then we will create another SSIS variable that will be used to store the full path of the file, CSV file. So it will be file path, and you know, the data type will be string, and let's leave it blank for now. And then we will be using a loop counter, so it will store the current counter value for the for loop. So for example, first time the value of the loop counter will be 1, then second time it will be 2, 3, and so on. Okay, so we have set the initial value as 1, and then let's create another SSIS variable that will be max territory ID. Okay, so the max territory ID in this particular case is 10, but this value, you know, we will pick from the SSIS package itself, so we are not hard coding this for now. So let's leave it, you know, as 0 for now. Okay, so we have created 4 SSIS variables. Those will be used, you know, to execute this particular SSIS package. So first of all, let's drag and drop the execute SQL task that will read the max territory ID from this particular table. Okay, so let's name it get max territory ID, and then edit it, make a connection to the AdventureWorks database. Okay, our server name is Ahmed and the database name is AdventureWorks 2014. Click OK. Okay, so we have, you know, made a connection to the AdventureWorks database. Now it's time to put this particular query. select query that can read the max territory ID into this particular box, SQL query. Click OK. And then under the result set, we need to set it to single row because it's going to return a single row. And then we can, you know, assign that particular value, the max territory ID value, to the max territory ID variable. Click OK. So this particular task will actually read the max territory ID from the SQL server table and will store that value into an SSIS variable. Okay, max territory ID. Now it's time to, you know, drag and drop the for loop container inside the control flow windows. So just connect the execute SQL task with the for loop container and then configure the for loop container. So first of all, we will start the for loop container with assigning the value of the loop counter. So initially the loop counter value will be 1. So the loop counter will start with the value 1 and then it will run until the value is less than or equal to the value of max territory. Okay, so max territory ID. Okay, so the loop will run until the loop counter value is less than or equal to the max territory ID, and then, you know, we will increment the value of loop counter with loop counter plus 1. So for example, first time the value will be 1 and then it will be 1 plus 1, so 2. Okay, so we have configured our for loop container, you know, to loop from 1 to the max value of the territory ID. Click OK. Now drag and drop a data flow task into the control flow window. So this particular data flow task will actually export data to CSV file. Okay, so just double click data flow task to configure it and then go to the SSIS toolbox. So, you know, we are going to read data from a SQL server table, so we will be going to use the OLEDB source for that particular purpose. Right click and edit the OLEDB source. Our connection manager is connecting to the, you know, AdventureWorks 2014 database, and then go to the SQL command here, and then, you know, just copy this particular query that will read data from customer table for a particular territory ID, paste it here. And, you know, as we are going to read the data for all territory ID one by one, so replace the 2 with a question mark and then assign a parameter value to it. So, you know, the value will be provided with a parameter. So variable will be counter loop, because counter loop value will be, you know, changed every time a counter will be iterating. You know, for example, first time it will be 1, 2 and so on. So click OK. So we have configured our OLEDB source and now it's time to, you know, write data to a CSV file. So as we are going to write data to a CSV file, so we're going to use the flat file destination. So connect OLEDB source with the flat file destination. Double click flat file destination to configure it. Click new to create a new connection to the CSV file. Choose the format of the CSV file. So in this particular case, we will be going to use the delimited. Click OK. And then name the connection manager as CSV files. And let's create a basic CSV file, you know, that we can initialize, you know, for first time. So the table name is customer. So our customer, the name of the CSV file will be similar, something like customer1.csv. okay, so the first, you know, the first file will be customer1.csv, another one will be customer2.csv, and so on. So go back to the BIDS and then browse to this particular file, change it to CSV files, and then customer1.csv. Click OK. Text qualifier will be double quotes, so all our column values will be, you know, in between the double quotes text qualifier. And then check the column names in the first data row. So each CSV file will have a column header in the first row. And then click the preview, click OK, and then go to the mappings to make sure that all columns from source have been mapped with the destination. Then click OK. Now it's time to actually, you know, set the dynamic values for the CSV file, because you know right now there is a hard-coded value C files customer1.csv. So if you will execute the SSIS package for now, so what will happen is a single file customer1.csv will be created every time, you know, so all data will be merged to a single file. So we want to create a new file every time the loop will continue, so we need to set the names dynamically. So click on expressions, go to the connection string, then click expressions. Okay, so we need to make the name of the file as dynamic values. So under double quotes, take, you know, put the value of the folder path. So our files will be situated at this particular location, C files, and then put double quotes. So you know our files will be situated at this particular location. The name of the file will be customer, and then we need to, you know, put the value of the counter here, so that, you know, these values, the file number will come from an SSIS variable loop counter, and as the loop counter is of integer type, so we need to convert it to a string value. So we need to convert it to tt_wstr,12. Okay, so our file name will be something like csv. Okay, so the file name will be c files customer1.csv. so loop counter value will change every time the loop will run. So now we should be good to create, you know, one file for each territory id. Click okay. So now we have configured our SSIS package successfully, and you know, if you will execute this SSIS package, so the first execute SQL task will actually read the max territory ID from the SQL server table, and then the loop will run through all the territory IDs from 1 to the max territory ID, and it will increase the value of the loop counter by 1 every time. And then inside the data flow task, it will read the values from the customer table for the current territory ID. And you know, this territory ID value is coming from a loop counter, so the territory ID will be similar to the value of the loop counter, and then we will read data from here, and then we will write data to this particular CSV file. So this particular CSV file is actually, you know, going to write the data to a customer n.csv file. Okay, so let's execute the SSIS package. So we just run the package, and you know, it should have exported data to, you know, 10 different CSV files, because we have max territory ID as 10. So you know it has exported data to the 10 CSV files. So if you open this particular file, so you will notice that, you know, the territory ID is 1 for all these records for this particular file, and for example for this particular file the territory ID should be 5 for all the records. Okay, so thanks guys for watching the video, and if you like the video then please click the like button and do subscribe to our channel to see more videos on SSIS. Thank you.